Hello and welcome to another edition of Cruz'N With Science. I'm your host for today, Mr. Cruz, and this is the show that uses discovery and exploration to take you on a magical tour through the world of science. And on today's show, we have a very special guest. This special guest is a young lady that wrote into the show and asked several questions about an episode we had done in the past called Cloud in the Bottle, and she wanted to know how air pressure affects everything that's around us. So I'm going to bring this young lady on the show today and do a couple really cool air demonstrations to show her just how powerful air is in our atmosphere. So without hesitation, let's bring out our special guest today. Her name, Zaricide Hernandez. Come on out, Zaricide.
Welcome to the show,
Zaricide.
Thank you.
All right, it's great to have you on here. So I heard you had some really good questions about the atmosphere and air pressure.
I did.
Okay, great. So I'm going to hope to answer some of those questions today by showing you how powerful air is through a couple demonstrations. And even though you can't see it, air's all around us and it has an impact on what we do every day, okay? So the first thing I'm going to want you to do is I'm just going to want you to grab this little mat here and you're just going to lift it straight up in the air. Sound pretty good?
Mm-hmm.
All right, go for it.
Miss Cruz, are you forgetting something?
She's right. Let's not forget those safety goggles. Let's get those bad boys on because this one could pop our eyes out. Okay, so you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Just pull that straight up. Should be pretty easy. Okay, here, let me give that a shot there. Try that again. I don't understand this. It's supposed to be pretty easy to pick this right up. All right. Zaricide, this is actually a little science trick here. What we have going on, got it up. What we have going on right now, the reason you couldn't lift that, because this is almost exactly how a suction cup works, and a suction cup doesn't actually suck anything. What it does is it uses air pressure that's pushing straight down on the mat, and that air pressure doesn't allow you to lift that up. In fact, air is so powerful, this is a cubic inch. For every one of these that would fit on this mat, there's 15 pounds of pressure coming straight down there. So what that means is you could probably fit about 100 of these around here. That's 15 pounds times 100 times of pressure going straight down. And that's a whole lot of pressure, okay? So that's why we couldn't lift it up, because there's air pressure acting straight down on it. Pretty cool, right? So let's get this out of the way. And we'll put that right there for now. And I'm going to do another really cool demonstration that may get you pretty wet here. You want to try it out? Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to get my cup of water. I'm going to pour a little bit of water in there. Don't want to get you too wet. And then I'm going to add my do not remove card. Because Mr. Cruz is getting a little old, and sometimes he forgets things. So all I'm going to do is dump this right over your head. Sound good?
Mm-hmm.
Let's do it. A little bit of water leaks out there. But what happens is, when I remove my hand, normally you would think gravity would take that water right on to your head, correct? I want you to take a look up. What's happening is air pressure is acting not only down, but also coming up. So that air pressure is keeping that card right in place and keeping you nice and dry. So we'll move this one right over here. That was pretty cool. And we're going to do one more to show the power of air. All right, this one may get you really wet. So we're going to put this right here. Don't forget the do not remove card. Put that on. Here we go. And voila. I want you to take a look at this there, Zaricide, and look straight on up. Now, why is she not getting wet? Well, what's happening here is I actually have a screen on here. Oh, no! I have a screen on here, And the only way you're going to get wet is if I actually shake it. Okay, so sorry about getting you a little bit wet there, Zarissa Day. I hope you don't mind. And what we're going to do is after the show is done, I'm going to allow Zarissa Day to try to dump some water on my head. So stay tuned for that because we'll put that at the end of the show and we'll see if Zarissa Day is able to do the same type of science magic with the water that I just did. So I hope you learned a little bit about air pressure today and now you understand how air is moving not only down on us, but up on us and to the sides and coming in, and it has all kinds of effect on our weather and everything else going on around outside, okay? All right, hope you had a great time today. Zarissa Day, it was an absolute pleasure, and if you could head right on out here. If you would like to learn a little bit more about the science behind today's show, there's no doubt your local media center is the place to go. The first book I'd like to showcase today is called Up in the Air. And this is an exciting book that talks about air through poetry. So it's a really great read, and it takes a different look at air in the atmosphere. And I highly recommend this one. And the other book, if you want to learn some experiments, this is called Experiments with Air. And this book will go through all kinds of really cool different experiments and demonstrations that you can do with air in our atmosphere. So Up in the Air, Experiments with Air, two books I highly recommend. And most likely, they're already gone. It has been another fantastic show. I'd like to thank Zarissa Day for coming today. She asked some great questions about air and air pressure, and hopefully we answered some of those about how the air, because it's a gas, it's putting pressure down, it's coming up, it's coming from the sides, it's really all around us, and it's amazing we're not walking around with all that air pressure and our eyeballs aren't just shooting right out. So, Zarissa Day, thanks again. I hope you had a great time. And please stay tuned because after our show, I let Zarissa Day try to dump water on top of my head. So we got some video of that when the show's over, so stay tuned. You don't want to miss that. Will she get me all wet? That's the question. All right, so for JT, who's looking good in his new shirt, Mr. Cruz, it's been a pleasure, and we'll see you next time on Cruz'N with Science.